The National Civil Rights Museum is located at the Lorraine Motel. The Lorraine Motel was built in the 1920s, and in 1945, Walter and Lori Bailey purchased the motel and renamed it the Lorraine after Mrs. Bailey and the Nat King Cole song, Sweet Lorraine. So in 1968, Dr. King was here to support the sanitation workers strike and had come to lead a nonviolent march to demonstrate the workers' humanity in support of the sanitation strike. And he was tragically killed on the balcony of room 306 at 6:01 p.m. on April 4th, 1968. The year they walked, the Montgomery Bus Boycott. In this gallery in the museum, what's compelling is when visitors come in, they'll notice that it's dominated by women, and that was not an accident. The success of the Montgomery Bus Boycott was due to the work of women, and that there were many women like Rosa Parks who were arrested for taking a seat and standing up for equality. Rosa Parks was more than the woman who said no. A lot of people limit her to that particular moment, but she was involved in the NAACP in Alabama for years. She decides to take a stand, and she is arrested on the bus. And so you'll see in this exhibit that we have three statues, and they're very lifelike, and the statues appear to be in motion, because that's what those women did. They walked to and from work for over a year. The sit-in movement is one of the more known movements of the civil rights time period. A lot of people think that it was just a simple thing that these students did, that they were 18 to 24 years old and they go in and they sit at the lunch counter and they just simply resist. The reality is that it's human nature to want to push back when someone pushes you or defend yourself when you are physically attacked. So in this gallery, we show footage from the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee being trained by Reverend James Lawson. These people had to be trained in nonviolent direct action. Also in this gallery, we highlight the different students involved, and a lot of people are surprised to learn that most of these folks who are participating in the sit-ins are 18 to 24 years old. A defining moment for the civil rights movement is the Memphis sanitation strike. On February 12, 1968, about 1,300 sanitation workers came together and walked out of their jobs and went on strike. So Reverend James Lawson, who had been a part of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, was now a pastor in Memphis and led the sanitation workers. So for weeks, they would meet at Claiborne Temple, African Methodist Episcopal Church here in Memphis, and walk from there to City Hall to demand their rights. So Dr. King hops in a cab, goes over to Mason Temple, and there he delivers his final speech, known as the Mountaintop Speech, where he talks about his work for the Poor People's Campaign, and he reflects on his life and legacy. That was the last public moment of Dr. King. He would be killed tragically on the balcony of room 306 on April 4th, 1968. And the country and the world wept and reacted at the loss of a nonviolent civil rights and human rights activist.